My name is Hauke Hillen. I am a research group leader at the Max Planck Institute for Biophysical Chemistry and a junior professor at the University Medical Center Göttingen. And in my research group, we are interested in understanding the structure and function of macromolecular assemblies, which we like to call molecular machines. So you have individual proteins which will actually come together and have to perform a certain task. And in order to understand how this works, one really has to actually take it apart like a machine. And in order to do that, we try to visualize these very small molecules using various techniques such as X-ray crystallography or cryo-electron microscopy. And these methods both allow us to get really high resolution information, which is crucial. So we are really talking of a resolution lower than 1 nanometer in order to really see at atomic detail how these molecules interact and behave and function. In particular, in our group, we are interested in little organelles within eukaryotic cells called mitochondria. And many people know these organelles from their, you know, basic biology class because they're often called the powerhouses of the cell. One thing that's very peculiar about mitochondria is that they have their own genome. And we are interested in how these genes are activated because they're very important, especially for this energy-producing function. And this happens by mechanisms that are actually different for the normal genes within the nucleus or for the nuclear genes. So they have specialized molecular machines for their gene expression. It's actually interesting for two reasons. The first reason is, of course, from a sort of basic biology standpoint, that it's a very different system. It's evolutionarily really only partly related to the nuclear gene expression system. So, for example, the mitochondrial gene expression system combines elements from nuclear gene expression, viral gene expression, and also bacterial gene expression. And the second aspect why it's very interesting is this disease aspect, that we know if things go wrong with mitochondrial gene expression, then we know this leads to disease. But we really don't understand very well how these mechanisms, why this leads to disease. I'm in a very fortunate position here because I have an affiliation with the university and with the MPI, and I'm very much looking forward, and I very much like about the research campus here is that I think it's really a unique place also within Germany with very close collaborations between the university and also the Max Planck Institute and very international students. So I'm very much looking forward to being able to interact with this international community and hope to also build a very international research team of my own.